You ever hear the phrase, money is power? I mean, think about it. If you have enough money, you could convince almost anyone to do anything. Fortunately, some people can't be bought by life's luxuries, and these are the kind of people who put them in place if they do something too crazy. Welcome back to Top 5 Central, everyone, where today we're looking at the 5 most ridiculous things millionaires have done, because, well, they're humans just like us. Click the like button if you wish you were a millionaire, and comment if you had $1 million, what would be the first thing you would buy? Would you be the generous millionaire type who donates to charity, or the type of dude who poops on a sidewalk every night? No, I'm not kidding, you'll hear about that later, but anyways, let's start with number 5. Everyone knows that love can make people do crazy things, but normally there are 2 things that stop people making stupid decisions: having sense and not having enough money. The thing is, Jocelyn Wildenstein literally has nothing but money, and it doesn't look like she has much sense either based on her decisions. So what crazy thing did love make her do? Well, it's a long story. The short version is that she grew up as a hunter and a pilot and fell in love with a rich dude in Africa who lived on a nature reserve. The guy loved his big cats, and he loved her as well, but apparently not enough to stop him sleeping with other people constantly. The poor girl was at her wit's end, so she did the only logical thing she could think of: getting plastic surgery to look more like a big cat? Yeah, you heard me right. This chick thought that if a surgeon made her look more like a lion or a tiger, her husband might fall in love with her all over again. Now, the word on the street is that it didn't work, so she wasted thousands of dollars on changing her face forever. But at least she'll never get confused for someone else at a party, so, you know, silver linings, I guess. Number 4. Sometimes it seems like people could get away with anything as long as they're rich enough, but I actually have some good news for you. This next guy, millionaire property owner Salvatore Serreto, actually did have to pay for his actions, and it's not surprising considering what he did. I mean, I actually can't believe I'm saying this, but he was found leaving gifts for local businesses in the middle of the night. I'm not talking about nice gifts either, like flowers or chocolate, but things that were a little more, personal? You know what, I'm just gonna come right out and say it. The dude was straight up dropping deuces on the pavement outside businesses he didn't like. There's no figuring out what this guy was thinking, but security cameras caught him walking to the businesses after dark with a roll of toilet paper, doing his business right there on the street, and then wrapping it up and leaving it for people to find. Gross, I know, but to be fair, he did tell police he had a very good reason, even if he wouldn't tell them what it was. Number 3. I'll bet at least everyone watching this knows at least one person who is way too obsessed with their dog, and it turns out that rich people are no different. I mean, Leona Helmsley was already kind of eccentric. Like, she was once convicted for millions of dollars of tax evasion and said in response that quote-unquote only little people pay taxes. Not only that, but she used to go swimming every day in her indoor pool, demanding that a servant in a suit and tie feed her shrimp from a silver platter at the end of every lap. Anyway, this very rich lady died aged 87, and she was just as odd in death as she was in life. Like, not only did she not leave 2 of her grandchildren anything, but the majority of her money went to her dog. That's right, her Maltese dog, which is called Trouble, funnily enough, got $12 million in her will, making it one of the richest and most spoiled dogs in the whole world. Now, I know what you're thinking, there's no way this story could get any stranger, but that's where you're wrong. The dog is actually famous in its own right. Like, it used to do ad campaigns and TV appearances and was famous for biting members of staff. And it actually had its own money in addition to the money its owner left. What a lucky dog, right? Number 2. You've all seen Jurassic Park, right? Well, I'm willing to bet this guy has too. Except he got the moral of the movie completely wrong. I mean, the whole point of the film is that cloning dinosaurs and building a theme park around them is a terrible, terrible idea. But that's exactly what Clive Palmer wants to do. Here's the thing, this Australian billionaire isn't actually a stranger to wild ideas. Don't believe me? Well, he also thought it would be a good idea to replicate the Titanic right down to the tiniest details just so he could sail the Titanic too and have it not crash. I mean, everyone has to have hobbies, and this guy just happens to like bringing disasters to real life. Anyway, I doubt that the Dino Park would happen in real life, but this guy is still throwing all of his energy, time, and money at the idea. Like, he's been in talks with the guys who cloned Dolly the sheep to see if it's actually possible to bring a T-Rex to life, and he's willing to cough up a heck of a lot of money to fund the project. Who knows, maybe they'll manage it, and people will be escaping from the terrifying theme park in a full-scale replica of the Titanic. What could go wrong? Okay, here's our first honorable mention. As ridiculous as it is, buying your own private island isn't actually that usual, especially if you're a billionaire. With that said, buying a private island and then writing your name on it big enough to be seen from space, well, that's a little bit, unusual? Basically, and I'm gonna totally pronounce this wrong, I apologize in advance, Sheikh Hamad bin Hamdan Al Nahyan is the dude behind the bizarre project, and he's also one of Abu Dhabi's ruling family. That explains a lot as to where he got the money from, and also why he has access to an island right next to Abu Dhabi, but it still doesn't explain why he did it. One day out of the blue, construction started work on the island, and it quickly became obvious that what they were building were canals. Like, the canals were in such a weird pattern that they obviously weren't functional, but no one could tell what they were actually for until they were done. When they were done, well, they definitely made an impact. The canal spelled out Hamad in huge capital letters that could be seen in orbit. A really weird thing to do, especially since most people don't mark their territory by writing their name on it. But what's even weirder is that a few months later, it just vanished, and nobody would say anything about why. Here comes honorable mention number 2. If this list has taught you anything, it's that people will do anything if they think they can get away with it, and rich people can get away with a lot. In fact, the only people who could get away with more than normal rich people who are also royal, and this next guy fits that exact bill. Al Waleed is a Saudi prince, and one who's famous for throwing some pretty outrageous parties. Now, to be fair, at this one, he was making a huge donation to charity, but I'm not sure that makes everything else that happened, well, okay. Here's the scoop. The dude had hired a bunch of little people to act as entertainment, because culturally, he believed that dwarves were lucky. They weren't just standing around or serving drinks either. The prince was throwing $100 bills into the fire and encouraging them to run into the flames and grab them. I don't need to tell you that's pretty horrific, but it gets even worse, because that isn't all he asked them to do. I'm not joking, he also held a dwarf throwing contest, kind of like Wolf of Wall Street, promising money to whoever could throw them the farthest, and set up a little pile of pillows in the corner of the room for them to land on. I mean, not the most humane party game if you ask me, but then again, I'm not royalty. Number 1. Now, if you had a massive amount of money and nothing to do with it, how would you spend it? Like, seriously, leave your answers in the comments, because I'm genuinely curious about what you do. With that said, I'm guessing none of you would decide to open a sperm bank for super geniuses, which is exactly what this guy did. It sounds really random, I know, but Clark Graham made millions inventing lenses for glasses that wouldn't shatter, and he only wanted to do one thing with all that wealth. The one thing that he was super passionate about was genetics, and he wanted to create a sperm donor company for crazy intelligent people. Sounds totally innocent, right? Well, it was at first, but the truth is, it ended up kind of Nazi-ish. Everyone donating had to be white, straight, and married, and anyone who wanted access had to be too. As soon as the press got hold of the idea, they called it eugenics, which made it so unpopular that most people refused to consider it altogether. I guess some ideas just aren't good ones, no matter how much money you have. And there's our video on the top 5 most ridiculous things millionaires have done with their wealth. If you enjoyed the video and you want to see more top 5s, make sure to click that like button and subscribe. You get notified every time we upload a video. Also, don't forget, we have a little handy form down in the description. You could submit your own top 5 or top 10 idea, and we might post it. So go ahead, go down there, submit it, and we'll see it there. With all of that said, thank you guys so much for watching. Hope you enjoy the video. Have a beautiful rest of your day, or sleep tight, because I'm sure a lot of you guys are watching this at like 3 a.m. But anyways, hope you enjoyed. We'll see you all in the next video.